What's up, everybody? JP back at you once again, bringing you guys another review on this late Wednesday night. It is week number 86 here on Body Bags. The theme this week is summer horror movies. I picked this theme because I thought it would be awesome to kind of wet our whistles on a little bit of horror films that take place in the summer, since summer is quickly approaching. The film that I chose this week is Super 8 from the year 2011. This film follows six young friends, probably about 13 or so, as they are starting their summer by filming a zombie movie with a Super 8 camcorder. You kind of have the director, who's like super serious about the whole thing, his best friend, who kind of has the crush on the girl who's going to be playing the lead character in the movie, and, you know, kind of the other side character friends. They're, you know, filming one night, they snuck out of the houses, and they see a train crash. They catch a little bit of it on their Super 8 camcorder, and something was up with the crash because it was military related, Air Force related. Something was in the cargo that was very dangerous. It gets loose, and now they're kind of caught in the middle of it, while still trying to make their Super 8 film. This film is very along the lines of Goonies and Gremlins and The Monster Squad. I absolutely had a blast with it. You have this sort of friendship that's going on in the summer. These kids are just trying to do what they want to do. In this case, in this film, it's make a Super 8 film, while in other films like The Goonies, it's to find One-Eyed Willy's treasure. It's the same sort of thing. I love the fact that these kids are mature. They're not little children. They are as mature as I was at that age. A lot of times in films, people kind of underplay how intelligent and, you know, smart kids actually are at the age that they are. And that always kind of annoys me. But these kids talk like real kids. They act like real kids. They care about the things that kids care about. And it's not sort of the version of kids that is typically portrayed in films. And I just love that. I feel like that any, kid around the age of these characters would just completely identify with them because they are one of them, and it is done very, very well. There's a lot of like mystery and wonder and imagination going on in this film that just, you know, bleeds through. You can just tell that it was supposed to capture that feeling of everything being so grand and great when you're a kid, and everything feeling so big and adventurous. I will say that the thing that was in the cargo might have been a little on the weaker side. It was okay. I was kind of just wanting something a little different. But it's not really what was in it that the story was about. It's, you know, what's happening because of it. You don't really need something to be super cool when you're dealing with the cargo, but it would have helped if it was, you know, a little cooler. I also will say that these characters are really cool, but at the same time, they just felt like they were missing a little bit. If, you know, to compare a film again with The Goonies, each and every one of the Goonies was super unique, had great character development, and were a completely fleshed out character. These ones, for example, one of the friends is like a firecracker nut. Like, he loves like fireworks and he makes homemade ones and stuff. But it's such a basic character trait that they don't really flesh the character out more. It's like this one likes this, this one likes this, but it's on a very simple and shallow level. They really don't go into it and really flesh out these characters, and I would have loved to see them do that. They do well with the two main male characters, the one director and, you know, kind of our lead hero character. They do a pretty good job with them. Everybody else was kind of background characters, which was a little disappointing. There was a lot of subplots going on in this film, a few metaphors and things like that. I thought it was really good stuff, but just picking out the small little things that I thought could have been better. overall, still, I think this is a fantastically fun film, and I was actually a little surprised that I had not seen it, and I do remember people kind of saying that it was just okay, but I thought it was way better than okay. This is a great, fun time. Very much enjoyed this. I give it about an 8 out of 10. It's definitely highly recommended for me. It will recapture those feelings and nostalgic memories that you had when you was a kid. Truly amazing stuff. I love that nostalgic vibe, and this film does a great job with it. So yeah, check it out if you haven't, and I'll see you guys next time with another review. Peace out.